of the table view, okay, let's say, and we have 100 items to be listed, okay, 100 items, let's say size of the table view is, the size of an iPhone is 320, 480, so let's say 320, 460, okay, 460 is the height, okay. So we show cells like this inside. Each cell, I'm representing the cell like this. The sorry. So the width between these two lines is the cell, let's say, okay, and the height of, I mean, dimensions of a cell or of each cell is, let's say 320, we use the entire width, and let's say this is let's 90. Okay, so the number of cells, I mean, the next cell starts at with a little gap. You understand the structure here, Krishan?
Yeah. Uh-huh. No, I understand.
Okay. So, for example, like this. So, you see, this is the cell here, image, and I mean the content inside, and there is no different. I mean, distance between the cells here. There is no distance between the cells here, but sometimes they might be. We don't have a distance there too, but virtually we can maintain distance. But let's say, one moment. Okay, let's say, okay. So these two are the cells here. Okay. So how many cells do you think fit in 460? With each cell size ranging from 320, 90. How many cells do you think will be fit in this complete view? Maybe 5, right? Starting from the top.
Yeah. Right. 5.
But you, if you have number of cells like 20. So how much do you think, we need a distance of,
so rho is nothing but a cell, yes?
Yes, rho is nothing but my cell.
Okay.
A cell is a, in the table view, each rho is a cell.
Okay.
So, I refer rho to a cell here, we refer rho to a cell here, okay, table view cell.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
So how much size do you think is required? It's like 1800, right?
Yeah, right.
1800, right? So if we want to take a scroll view in this case, so the scroll view dimensions will be, frame will be 00, 320, 460, but scroll view content size will be 320, 1800, right? So
yeah.
If you scroll it, you scroll through the cells, right? So yeah. This our table view is nothing but is an inherited class of table view inherits scroll view. Okay. So, I mean, all the properties of a scroll view apply to the table view here. So, for example, we have discussed some properties like content offset, go to content offset, and convert rect. Content offset, convert rect, convert point, zoom, zoom scale. Everything applies to table view too. Got it? But apart from that, it has its own properties, many properties of the table view. Okay? You got it, Krishna?
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, sure. So, let's go back to the presentation. So, this is a plain style here. In a table view, we have many things here, many sections of many things in a table view here. So, this particular thing is called header. Okay. So, we have header here, sections, rows. You see this, Krishna?
Yeah.
You understand what I mean?
Yeah.
Okay. So, this is the table view header. There will be number of sections here. Each section will have section header, section footer, and the cells inside. Section header, section cells, and section footer. And the next one here. Next section. You can set as many number of sections you want. So, for example, let's say if you take this one here. Okay. Let's say settings. Hardware. Yeah. Okay, you see here there are 1, 2, 3, 4 sections here. There are 4 sections here, and a table you can have as many number of sections you want, and each section will have a section header, a section footer, and number of cells inside. So in this case, we don't have section header and section footer for each section. You got it? First section has only Bluetooth here as the cell, and the next section has 2 cells here. Third section has 3 cells. Fourth section has 2 cells. Because I mean, sectioning is nothing but classification of the content you have. Okay, got it? You understand what I mean, Krishna?
Yeah.
Okay. So you can set a difference between, I mean, you can expand the footer here such that gap between 2 sections. Okay.
Mm.
You can give, for example, you can give a new view to the header. You can give a new view to the footer. You can give new view to the each row. It all depends on how you want the content to be presented in your table view. Got it?
Yeah.
Okay. So in this case, you see, he explained the same way. Group style. Table view header, header 0, footer, header 1, footer. Sections or not. Most of the times, you don't see sections. For example, in this C, this one doesn't have the sections, but this one has. Got it?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. So, any types of cell types here? One moment, Krishna. Give me 2 minutes. I'll just have some water and come back.
Sure.
So in the meanwhile, have a look at this current types, right?
Sure.
Hello.
Hello. Yeah.
Hey, sorry, Krishna. Yeah. So yeah, you understand what I mean here. I mean,
right.
You can have the content to be presented as you want. I mean, there are many different types of presentation here, but here you see UI table view style subtitle, UI table view cell style default, UI table view style value 1, value 2. There are many styles. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So. This is all explained how you can create a table view with respect to MVC, okay? With MVC architecture, with MVC concept as such. Okay. So there's something called UI table view controller, and you can that gives a UI table view by default as a member to it, okay? Maybe we might want to try this in the live explaining this one here. So maybe or just go through and then come back. Creating generally. Okay. Let's not get into this. Okay. So, table has two properties. That is, table view data source and table view delegate class. Okay, data source means, so it can be a list. So you give a list to a table view, and it automatically takes each object in that list as a cell inside. Got it? You understand what I mean? So So yeah, list in the sense, for example,
you got it right.
So the first object in the list will be the first object in the cell. So that's how it automatically takes. For example, if you scroll it, then it automatically takes the, you know, with the content offset, you table you knows at which cell it is at. So it takes a particular cell. It takes a particular object from the list and assign it to the cell. Okay. So here one more concept I want to tell you is, that's a very important thing. That is, for example, as we discussed in this view, there are only 5 cells possible in the view, right? But the number of cells are 20. So for each cell, it has to allocate some memory, right?
Okay.
So what does it do is, if you scroll it, it doesn't allocate new cells, but it just fills the new contents inside. Let me explain it in detail here. This is the third cell. Okay, so in this case, for example, let's say 450. So you have only 5 cells possible, right? In this case, right?
Mm-hmm.
At most 5. Mm-hmm. But if you are scrolling through, you can view up to 6 cells, one at the top and one in the bottom and 4 in the middle. Got it?
Yeah.
So at most 6 cells can be viewed at a time, even though partly. So it assigns, it allocates memory for only 6 cells. And if you scroll through, it changes the contents in the cell, but it doesn't allocate new memory for the cells. So that's how it is memory conservative.
So whatever is the frame size available, only those will fill the memory.
Exactly. That automatically will be taken care by table view itself. Just need to write one line inside to use the same to have the reuse of the cell. That's it. Got it? So if there is a possibility for reusing of a cell, it automatically takes care of it. If it doesn't have the possibility of reusing a cell, then only it actually creates new memory for the cell. Okay. And then now coming back to our presentation. So it all explains here how a data source can be linked to a table view and how what happens with each table view, you know, click and everything. Yeah. Krishna, maybe. It